Our first speaker this morning is Christian Capella from Vienna. He's talking about his master's work, although he's now working at AIT in Vienna. And he's going to talk to us about objective and subjective evaluation of multi-stereo 3D reconstruction. Over to you, Christian.
So thank you for a kind introduction. As you said, this project was part of my master thesis, and in this talk I will go into the updated results of a new user study with it. My talk will be structured like that. I will introduce you to our problem, the problem we would like to solve. I will show you how we acquired our data and our reconstruction pipeline, and finally I go into the evaluation of the models we acquired. And we go into the objective evaluation using validation models and the subjective user study we did. And I'll end my talk with a short conclusion. So we are into acquiring 3D models for VR or for the media production industry, where you would want to have them, for example, for virtual avatars and so on. And if you're acquiring data with such systems, you have the problem that you want to evaluate your own data and want to see how good it is. And usually, if you're working on an algorithm, you would have some high-quality ground truth data set. But once you get your own sensors and put them in another place or have a different kind of sensing modality, you're out of luck and you have to do your own thing. And this is what I'm trying to do to show you here. So this is our system. We had three stereo cameras. They're facing around the central scene spot. And we're having passive stereo sensors. They are all synchronized together. And the cameras deliver something like 5 megapixel images at a frame rate of 25 frames per second. So here you can see our reconstruction pipeline. We start by calibrating the sensors internally and extrinsically, so we know the pose among the sensors. And then we will go into the studio, we'll acquire our actors, and do depth reconstruction using a stereo matching algorithm, and can project this data back into 3D space. And since we are only interested in the actors, we're also doing some segmentation, so only the actors themselves will be left. And we then take these point clouds we will get and from the individual views and fuse them using a surface reconstruction algorithm. And this will give us our final result. So now I go into how we would evaluate our data. We are mostly interested in two aspects. The first would be accuracy. How good is our system that we're working with to reconstruct stuff that it sees? For that, we are doing an evaluation on validation objects. And the other kind of evaluation for accuracy would be a novel view evaluation, where we would just take two of reconstruct your models from two of the three sensors and use the third one as an independent source of validation. And the most important metric you would acquire for your 3D models would be the judgment of your final users, because the models are intended for viewing, and so their judgment is the best metric you can get. For that, we are doing a subjective user study. In this talk, I'd like to focus on the validation objects in the user study. For the novel view evaluation, please, you can consult my master thesis. And yeah, let's go into the system evaluation. So we are having validation objects. They comprise spherical objects. And we do this because spheres have the nice property of being very simple. They are completely determined by a position in 3D space and the radius. So we will take multiple acquisitions of these spheres. As you can see them, we have a green one and a blue one. They are rather large, so they cover significant amount of their field of view. And then we generate point clouds and fit ideal spheres, because we know the radius, into this data. And once we have that, we can see which points, reconstructed points, lie within some threshold and which lie outside. This would be an example of our of our results. Here you can see the original sphere reconstructed, as you can see it from a sensor from front, and everything looks nice. But once you turn your view to the side, like down here, you see that your data is quite noisy. So here we have the fitted spheres overlaid with the data, and on the right side we can see the green points are those within the outlier threshold, and the red ones are outside of the radius and outside of the threshold. The yellow ones are inside the sphere and inside the threshold. So you can then run, make a graph, and say, okay, when my error threshold would be that. You get the amount of points that lie within your threshold, and in this case we, for example, reached 90% of inliers at 12 millimeter plus minus around the sphere. What? Sorry? So let's go into the subjective evaluation. For that we did some data sets from actors. This is me and this is my colleague Braulio the Bear. And this is the stuff we have shown to our users. In the subjective evaluation, we checked two specific steps in our reconstruction pipeline. The first one would be the depth generation. We looked into three different algorithms for generating 3D points. The first one would be the baseline, which is a cost volume filtering with integer disparities. It gives you only a very coarse reconstruction of along the z-axis, while you can do a bit better if you're doing some disparity refinement within. Here you can see the yellow points are the depth refined points with the integer disparities overlaid for reference. So your points will disperse better and give you a better reading. The third algorithm we had was a patch match algorithm, here in pink. This is this would be a result that would also would be given to, is similar to something you would get from a learning-based approach. And the second step of our reconstruction pipeline we looked into was how we would fuse our single views into combined ones. We checked the fusion before the surface reconstruction and the fusion after the surface reconstruction, which gives us in the end six different approaches we try to compare and show to our users. So we set up a subjective user study in pair comparison mode. Since the output of our six different approaches was quite similar, we also opted for a no preference option. So if a user wouldn't be able to discern two different models shown to them, they could also say, no, I cannot tell. So we had 40-minute trials, one person at a time, and we had 22 participants, both experienced and inexperienced, quite well balanced, also regarding sexes and a broad range of ages. So in each trial, a user would undergo a screening. He or she would have to be able to discern have a good visual acuity and would be able to discern colors. And we showed the material we showed to our users were pre-rendered videos from several points of view, with the rationale being that they didn't have to navigate the 3D data themselves, and so we could try to avoid biases from that. Since we had six different approaches, we had in the end 75 comparisons. So we would want to restrict ourselves in the length of the material you could show, we could show. So we opted for 15 seconds, which turned out to be a rather good total time for users. More of them, they would say it's too hard to do it, to do the evaluation for them. So we would also show them one model at a time, and the users were able to switch between them overlaid, so they could visually compare those two kind of approaches they saw. This would be an example of one of the videos we've shown, again, Baulieu. And you see that the viewpoint is changing from the one from one sensor to the middle one and to the left one, and finally. And these are the results we came out with. We saw that concerning the depth reconstruction approaches, the patch match algorithm would be the best, quite consistently. Then afterwards, we saw we have the depth refined disparities, and last was the baseline algorithm, the integer disparities. And concerning view fusion, we saw that the fusion before model generation was clearly the better option. So concluding, I've presented to you an evaluation framework for self-acquired 3D models. You can apply this kind of evaluations to not only to passive stereo sensors but also for other sensing modalities. It comprises of an objective evaluation using validation models, and the subjective evaluation is done by paired comparison. In the system we've looked into, we got 90% of inliers for the spheres, and in our subjective evaluation we compared 6 different approaches. So what we didn't go into in this evaluation was to look at the calibration of the depth sensors themselves. We also we assumed that it would be good enough. But this is also something you very much want to go through if you're doing testing a production setup. So with this, I'm done, and thank you, and I'm happy to answer your questions.